For a business, nothing says success like a line down the block. And for LA's Pink's Hot Dogs, they've got that down pat. But even though things are going well, owners Gloria and Richard Pink are always looking to step things up.
Any business that isn't improving is falling behind.
Yeah, we're always looking for ways to improve the business.
The Pinks were clearly crazy about their brand, but when I went undercover to scope things out, I discovered a glaring problem that was keeping them from making even more money. So I paid the couple a visit with a way to attract a new type of customer.
I wore a pink shirt today because your name is Pink's.
Right, yeah. Okay.
Right now, the huge line at Pink's is turning off a slew of customers that don't have time to wait. But Richard and Gloria would easily be able to capture those sales with a simple rule change. Line cutting allowed if you're in a hurry.
I hate to like prejudge it, but customers that saw that someone else got an advantage would probably be upset.
I want you guys to know that I'm determined to protect your brand at all costs.
All right, so let's see how you do that.
Okay.
Okay.
The Pinks agreed to let me prove my idea to them during the Friday lunch rush. So the next day, I placed a sign near the street advertising the new rule. To avoid chaos by everyone saying they were in a rush, I came up with a list of 5 acceptable reasons for cutting to the front of the line. Doctor's appointment, job interview, picking up a kid from school, funeral, or if you're an air traffic controller who's late for work. The new policy seemed to be attracting customers who were driving by, even though most of them didn't qualify for line cutting.
No. I'm a pilot, but I'm not a...
But you're not an air traffic controller?
No.
But there were several people with legitimate places to be.
You have a doctor's appointment
today?
Yeah. And who's your doctor?
Dr. Paya.
Dr. Paya?
Dr. Paya's office.
Hi, I'm calling to confirm an appointment for...
Jason?
Wolf?
Yeah, we have Jason coming in at 5:30.
Great, okay, thank you so much.
And once I was able to confirm their reason...
He has to cut in line as a doctor's appointment, is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay.
Customers could cut to the front of the line without anyone getting angry. As the day went on, the system seemed to be working great.
You are going to a funeral?
Yeah.
Really? Who's the funeral for?
Connie Mandel. Friend of mine.
Oh, I'm so sorry for your loss.
Okay.
But as the lunch rush was winding down, I saw something that disturbed me. One customer that I met earlier said he was in a hurry.
I have a doctor's appointment. I forgot.
You have a doctor's appointment
yeah.
today? You really do?
Mm-hmm.
But when I tried to confirm it, he couldn't give me any information.
What's your doctor's number? Or
I don't have his number. I don't have it with me. I just have to go at 3.
Giving him the benefit of the doubt, I allowed him to cut to the front. But now, 45 minutes later, he was still sitting there, taking his time. And I began to suspect that he didn't have a doctor's appointment at all. So I told one of my cameramen to secretly follow him to his car. And once he drove off, I followed in close pursuit to see if he was telling the truth.
Bit late for the doctor by now, aren't we?
After 30 minutes of tailing him, he led us straight into a lie. He wasn't going to the doctor. He was seeing a movie instead. An excuse that wasn't on my list. It was an unbelievable slap in the face to the Pink's name. So that evening, I returned to the restaurant to see how Gloria wanted to handle this.
So he cut in line, got his food, and then later...
He went to see a movie. You know, I think if you don't do something to respond, it could make you as a brand look weak.
Well...
So with your permission, I'd like to take this guy on a boat, and then once he's trapped at sea, teach him a lesson he'll never forget.
Whoa. That's pretty harsh.
After my conversation with Gloria, Richard escorted me out and said that he no longer wanted my help at Pink's. But when I make a promise to a business,
I'm determined to protect your brand at all costs.
I always keep it. And that meant I had to show this guy on my own what happens when you mess with Pink's. So using the number from his appearance release, I told Jonathan I was calling from the Pink's head office with some exciting news.
You, my friend, are the 10 millionth Pink's customer.
Oh my God, are you serious?
I am serious. You have won a lobster lunch for one at sea.
At what?
At sea.
Oh, thank you. I'm so excited. Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Jonathan bought it, hook, line, and sinker. So I docked a boat in the San Pedro Harbor, and then sent a limo with two hired models to keep the ruse going on the way to the sea.
I'm so excited to be the 10th millionth customer of Pink's. I love their hot dogs. I'm so excited to represent them.
Once Jonathan arrived, I had him right where I needed him, and he was about to learn that taking advantage of Pink's does not go unpunished. Shortly after, we headed out to sea, and Jonathan had no idea that his life was about to change forever.